I always liked the sea, and when I was a kid, basically there were sort of lots of things on the telly about diving and marine animals and this sort of thing. So my first interest as a young teenager was I wanted to be a diver.
All my childhood, I always loved like the David Attenborough programmes. I was always insisted that we watch them. I think growing up, like, I grew up on a farm as well, so I've always been like surrounded by animals, and I've always been asking my dad, like, oh, why do the cows do stuff like this?
One of the things that this degree is particularly good at, or particularly important for, is it's all research-led.
You are quite likely to get a lecture which includes a paper that came out in Nature this week.
Most people that join us in the first year really haven't got the basic stuff. So you might know how to run a gel, or you know how genetics works, but I bet you don't know the difference between a spruce tree and a larch tree, or a sea squirt and a sea cucumber. If you do, I apologise, but you may not. So we assume that, in fact, we sort of assume nothing.
First year gets everybody to the same level. So it might be that you do stuff that you've covered before at school, but then you'll be sitting next to somebody that hasn't covered it at all.
We have the first year field course, which is an enormously important bonding, networking event.
You do a little bit of everything very quickly in each day, so that really gives you a hit of startup course in field work, and that's really useful in the first year.
The students get to know each other, and you get to know the staff a little bit, whether it's in the rocky shore, or in the woods, or in the pub.
And then once you get into second year, there's six blocks of lectures, and you do quite a lot of statistics in second year.
The rigidity of the Oxford course is actually a real selling point because of biology. I think you need a solid grounding of knowledge in all topics in order to specialise.
If you don't go to a course with such a broad range, then you don't get exposed.
But I think one of the things that we try and instil in our new students is a curiosity in terms of what's in that pool, what's up that tree, what's in that cell.
All the time that we're in lectures, I'll be sitting with my friends and we'll be like, you hear things it changes the way you've kind of thought about stuff before.
How little we did on human biology was probably my biggest surprise, because at school a lot of the biology A-level course is quite centred on human biology, whereas at university the big shift is realising that humans are one tiny branch.
The crucial point about biology here is it's a skills-based degree, and we're very keen that our students not only learn sort of the theories and the concepts, but they also end up being good at things.
You feel like a real scientist, you're doing stuff, and it's not like school experiments at all, they tend to work.
You will find, at first, very difficult sort of time management problem, in that it's a very busy week.
Two lectures a day, and one 3-hour practical every other day, plus a tutorial, plus some statistics classes. So you don't come to Oxford for a free ride.
You have quite a lot of lectures, which some courses don't have, but it makes you feel productive.
The third year is where students can really explore their own choices.
Part of your final honours is doing an extended project.
There are so many optional extras that you could choose a project almost from an infinite list.
So I've chosen to do it's an ecology kind of evolutionary based project, which is in Indonesia. We're going to be working on fiddler crabs.
I'm doing my dissertation in Madagascar. I'm working in the dry forest in the northwest. I'm doing lemur ecology.
We just want people to be, while they're here, absolutely enthralled, captivated by the subject, and prepared to go that extra mile to really work their socks off to find out things.
I honestly can't think of a student I've met in the last 5 years who has been bored by the course. Whether you're interested in microbes or man or anything in between, we've almost certainly got someone that can teach you something about it.
We have our own wood, we have our own botanic gardens and University Museum of Natural History and all these sort of things. I think as a package, I would say we are unique.
The labs are really modern. I mean, a lot of the teachers are really experts in their field, and that is a huge thing to have people that are teaching you know are world experts, and that really is the main thing for me, I guess.
I think what makes Oxford distinctive, apart from the breadth, is the way that it's taught. So we do have lectures, we do have practicals, but we have this strange thing, or these strange things called tutorials. From the first week that a student's here, they're expected to discuss difficult biological ideas with someone like me, with no hiding place, no way of trying to bluff your way through it. And you have to enjoy that.
While you're in the room and you're discussing what the essay topic, you normally go a bit further than what you've covered in your essay. And they shine like a new light on it, and they say something and you'd be like, oh, I've never even considered that.
I learn a lot more in tutorials than in lectures. It's worth sort of 5 or 6 lectures to me just to have a one-on-one or 2-on-1, even 4-on-1 meeting. You just talk a lot, and it just helps me learn and know that lectures really can't do.
And it's so good if you've got any questions. It's like they never ever mind you asking a question, no matter how trivial it is.
The tutorial sort of does require you to, you know, to really put yourself on the line periodically and defend your ideas.
I take a lot less at face value. I think Oxford makes you kind of like question everything.
The nice thing about Oxford is the terms are only 8 weeks long. So if you pace yourself, you need to fall over on Friday afternoon of 8th week. Well, probably after you've been to the college pop. So Saturday morning when your parents come and pick you up, you should be absolutely exhausted.
What's really important is your academic, intellectual achievements, and as I said above all, your potential and your passion.
I didn't really expect myself to get into Oxford, I kind of just applied on a whim.
Since you have the interview process, it gives you a really good insight into what Oxford's like, and you come here so you can see just the city, and that's quite a big decision really. If you haven't visited the place, it's really hard to know if it's right for you.
An interview is about talking about biology. School very much is about writing biology, and they're different skills.
You need to talk to us. We need to hear what you say, we need to hear you answering our questions, and we need to listen to you thinking out loud and this sort of thing.
They wouldn't say to you, like, give me the species name of this insect. Like, it's not questions like that at all. It's just, they just want to talk to you and see how, because it is quite similar to a tutorial, to see if you're suited to the tutorial way of learning.
The crucial point to say to you, as a nervous person, is that we will not be unkind.
Martin opened by asking me to imagine I was a barnacle, which is quite a surreal experience. And I then had to sort of tell him my way through my problems.
We understand entirely that you could have a burning interest in ornithology and bird watching, of course, but not have any opportunity to do it. So we're much more interested in some ways in a potential that you've got. So I always wanted to be a bird watcher, but I'd never had the binoculars.
If there isn't a biology club at school, stop. It's the best way of preparing.
People say, how can I prepare properly? Well, partly you can read current affairs, you can have opinions. The bottom line, though, is that you can't make yourself a biologist overnight.
I think the best advice I can give is be yourself. And we'll see what happens.
I got the letter through the post, and one letter was on top. Unfortunately, it had lots of fees information, so I spent a long time reading about how much it was going to cost before I really realised I got in.
Everyone that I spoke to had also enjoyed their interview, so that wasn't really an indication of how well it had gone. I was quite surprised. I was very happy.
Biology has an enormous breadth of choice after the first year. And therefore the career opportunities and everything else are wide open. People every year that do fast track graduate medicine or graduate veterinary, and I always try very hard to persuade people at 17, when they're considering being a medic right from the start, hang on, slow down a little bit. Perhaps you should do a general degree, like biology or biochemistry or that sort of thing, and then see if you still want to be a medic, and if you do, then you can do it as a graduate.
I'd definitely like to do something based in biology. So I've been looking at doing work on like kind of consultancy things, so helping people establish biodiversity or deal with a crop like pest.
If you have an idea that Oxford might work for you, or you might be interested, or your advisors, your parents, your teachers, or anybody else say, well, it's worth a try, give it a go.